minus for the Caracres.
Hello, welcome to Inside IRC, round 10, the Prima Yalta Rally in the Ukraine. Yes, the Yalta Rally, a big opportunity for some lesser-known drivers to show their talent on the international rally scene. Some unfamiliar faces, all, of course, with their very own story. Attended by the Ukrainian president, Yanukovych, the Yalta rally got underway on Friday. There were 14 stages ahead of everybody. Very, very tricky. Yes, difficult tarmac. Always, always tough to read. We knew that. Indeed. So did the participants. Time to get on with it. Two-time winner of the Yalta Rally in 2005 and 2008 in a production car, Yuri Protasov. Yes, first on the road in his Fiesta WRC. Yes, the 1.6 turbo run by the Italian A-style team, finding himself immediately right on the pace and taking the lead from stage one. Well, fastest on stage two, 1.9 ahead of Protasov, was Mikko Pajanen. Yes, sponsored by Tommy Makinen. Takes the overall lead, 1 second ahead of the Ukrainian. It was close up there. Third major protagonist, Yanis Avci. It's the Turkish driver. First stage on tarmac was stage one. He set the 11th quickest time, learning quickly. Third stage time on stage two, and gaining seven positions, climbing to third overall, just 11 seconds off the lead. So after the first two stages, Pajanen leading. 1 second only, though, ahead of Protasov. So, what about Mikko Pajanen?
Mikko Pajanen is 28-year rally driver. I haven't driven too long, because I started quite late. I was, I think, 23 maybe when I started.
Yes, indeed, and he invested his own money to get into rallying. Had a lot of self-belief. Tommy Makinen now backs that up. All that starting around 5 years ago.
So quite near Jyväskylä, which is the center of the Finnish rally. Sometimes we went to the lake ice, and there was a like circuit, and we were driving that. And someday I just bought a cheap rally car and started.
Mikko is not a professional rally driver just yet.
Taxi equipment to the taxi car. So in these days it's quite small time when I can go to work. So.
Well, the experienced Kai Lindström is reading the notes for Pajanen. Lindström was in the hot seat next to Tommy Makinen and Kimi Räikkönen. He judges the talent of Pajanen for us.
Base notes, he makes them very accurate, relies on them 100%.
also talented car handler for sure, but obviously all the segments needs to be improved before you are in the top level.
Want to watch then? So is Yuri Protasov. Vasis on stage three, taking back the overall lead, 11.6 ahead of Pajanen. Still looking for the right feeling, he said, with his Fiesta. Struggles a bit on the downhill section of stage four. On top of that, the tyre comes off the rim and lost him 18 seconds. Well, still just finding his feet on the S2000. Cautious at first for Pajanen. Well, despite bad tyre choice and too hard a compound, still his second stage win was to come his way. Stage four, taking back the overall lead, 6.4 ahead of Protasov. And Yagish Avci, well, still improving his tarmac style, suffering a handbrake problem on four, but still third fastest nonetheless, despite that. Still third in the overall standings, but already 1 minute and 11 down on the leader. Vasilevskiy, also the Ukraine, suffering engine problems on stage four, losing more than 5 minutes, forced to stop following the road section. Shame. Meanwhile, Marco Tempestini, there was two Tempestinis here, a bad morning for the family. Yes, father Marco, brake problems on the downhill section of stage four, losing two positions in the overall, dropping down as seventh. Meanwhile, keeping it in the family, Simone Tempestini, also in a Subaru Impreza STI, son of Marco, rolling on stage three, unfortunately. It didn't look comfortable. Managed to carry on despite the damage. Yuri Kochmar of the Ukraine, fourth fastest on stage four, taking advantage of Tempestini's brake issues, climbing to fourth overall and now leading the production cup. Yes, tightly fought, it was too. Yuri Protasov decided to attack on stage five after his mishap on four. Was fastest in the stage and snatched back the lead, 14.2 ahead of Mikko Pajunen. Fully committed, what was left for everybody else? Well, Vary Garban, yes, fourth stage time for the local production driver, climbing to seventh overall, third in the production cup. Mitsubishi Lancer Evo 9, there were three versions indeed here. Laszlo Vichin, sixth special stage time for the veteran Hungarian driver, going ahead of Kochmar and taking fourth spot overall. Not bad. Robert Cassani in the Megane RS, climbing up. Yeah, losing his brakes though at 12 kilometres from the end of stage five. Ended the stage quite cautiously, as you might imagine. Only the 11th special time, best time on the stage, 11th overall, but now fourth in the production cup and leading two-wheel drive. Vitaly Pushkar in the Evo 10, yeah, fifth overall, second in the production cup at the start of stage five, but slid off and sadly had to retire. Ouch. No need for those notes anymore. Protasov leading ahead of Pajanen and Avci. And as said, it was not a good morning for father and son Tempestini, for Marco and Simone. Tell you what, let's meet the Tempestini, shall we?
Marco De Festini is an old driver and around 50 years old, 20 years of rally, Italian gravel champion, East European champion in the Cup for two times, and a lot of passion in the family and everybody. We like very much motorsport.
And then there's Simone Tempestini. Carrying a little bit less baggage, I might add. Here he is.
Our family is a sportive family. We do a lot of sport, also my wife. And Simone, at 14 years old, was a little bit lazy at school. And we make a deal and say, okay, you go okay in school and I will give you the car if you want. He say yes. Now no problem on school and maybe problem in the competition, because last rally in Romania he was 20 seconds slower than me. So I think that in some rally he will be fight with me.
He helped me a lot of, very much, and this is good for me. My ambition is to be pass by pass faster than I am, and to be faster with time.
Welcome back to Inside IRC. It's the Prima Yalta Rally, stages 6 and 7 to come up. Pajanen, second at the start of stage 6, 14 seconds behind leader Protasov. Well, he upped the rhythm on board the Ford S2000, just trying to get closer to his nemesis. Finally, they're running out of luck on stage 6 and retired, sadly.
Quite full speed corner. It was in our note. It was full minus with Titans, and we had a little slide, and it took the grip and drove our car out of the road, and we hit a concrete pole and quite big wood, and it was quite bad accident.
They were lucky. Protasov had a very healthy lead at the start of the stage, but that was depleted. Yes, the puncture on 7 had to stop, change a wheel, losing more than 3 minutes, dropping to second overall. Well, with Pajanen out, who was the leader? The answer? The man has been taking it easy. Yagis Avci. Yes, getting the lead after Protasov's puncture, now 25 seconds ahead of Protasov, and looking good for that. Meanwhile, a Mitsu Lancer Evo 8. Remember those? Tommy used to make them sing. Yeah, his car has four wheels. He punctures 3 times. Goodness me. One wheel left on his wagon, then, you might think. Extreme bad luck for Koshmar. Had to retire. Stunning part of the world, this. Yuri Protasov, strong reaction after losing the lead on stage 7. Attacked yet again, all stage long. Yes, looked like he was very close to the edge. Took a 1 minute advance. How about that? Avci responding, still learning tarmac, don't forget. Second stage time, but dropping to second overall again. Yes. 38.3 seconds behind Protasov after having that advantage wiped away by the Ukrainian's pace. Laszlo Vyshin of Hungary, good performance. Good rhythm as well for Vyshin on board the Skoda S2000. Fourth stage time, but staying third overall. Marco Tempestini, P2. bad news for the production cup leader, hampered by gearbox lever problem, clocking only the 12th special stage time and losing the lead in the production cup at the same time. Robert Cassani, the Frenchman on board the Renault Mégane RS. Time to benefit from Robert Cassani. Third stage time, climbing to fourth overall and leading now in both the production and the two-wheel drive cup. It was a good run. Overall top five completed by a surprising Romanian, Vladimir Cosma, driving a Citroen C2 R2 Max. Vlad doing a proper job out there. But with Pynin out of the race, Protasov 38 seconds ahead of Avci. So with Protasov our leader, it's time to meet the man.
Yuri Protasov is champion of Ukraine 2008. Yes, but two-time win the Rally Yalta and five-time win the karting. All time have rally and circuit race a lot of.
That said, Yuri prefers rally. He finds circuit racing a bit boring, he says. Well, this is the first rally for him with the Fiesta 1.6 turbo. There's a lot of experience with turbo cars.
2-liter turbo car, all time. Evo, Subaru, all time. And for me, 1.6 turbo is, for me, the best. Not 8,000 all time, it's 5,000, it's better.
On to leg two, with six more stages then to tackle. Yuri Protasov suffering a puncture on stage 9, slipping off the road on 10, damaging the rear left suspension, losing about 2 minutes. Still second overall, not bad. Well, blocking Avci on the stage. It looks like a simulcam, but actually it's not. This is real cam. Well, taking the start of stage 11, trying desperately to get to the service part, but 5 kilometres into the stage, the left rear and the suspension completely destroyed. Had to park up and retire. Well, you saw Avci catching Protasov, and here it is on board. Stage 10 and 11 blocked, slowing down. Looking for that finish, but with Protasov's retirement, he's now way ahead in the lead, despite being hampered. 3 minutes and 39 ahead of the Hungarian Laszlo Vichin. And from now on, taking it slowly, even if it doesn't look that way. Marco Tempestini driving flat out to climb up the rankings. And on stage 9, takes his first quickest time in the IOC, climbing to 5th overall, 3rd in the production class. Shows what you can do. Robert Cassani doing another good job way up there on the stage. Strong lead in production and the two-wheel drive cup. Now third overall, but only 10 seconds behind Vichin. And what about our friend Vlad, the Romanian? Yes, Mr. Cosma, back on the pace with a fourth quickest stage time on 11, getting two positions in the overall and back up to fourth, still second in the two-wheel drive cup, 15.7 ahead of Tempestini. So Avci leading now, ahead of Vichin and Cossani. So, new leader, and as before, it must be time to meet him. So a healthy lead, but who is Yagis Avci? Let's find out.
I'm driving for 10 years and I'm last 3 years Turkish Rally Champion. I am 84, my birth year, and I'm from Turkey. This is our first outing in IRC. So it's a bit special for us. Yalta Rally, it means lots of experience on tarmac because we don't have much tarmac rallies. I studied mechanical engineering and we have a medium family company from my grandfather. Besides that, I am doing driving instructions and rally driving instructions.
The IRC's Premier Yalta Rally, three stages to go. Marco Tempestini still attacking to gain positions in the production cup. Fastest overall again on 12, his second stage win of the rally, but loses it all on stage 14, two punctures on 17.07 kilometres, losing almost 7 minutes, dropping down to 6th overall and to 3rd in the production cup. What a shame. What about our Vlad, Mr. Cosma, the Romanian, with his Citroen C2 R2, punctures front right on 13, loses 2 minutes and 45, but takes advantage of Tempestini's punctures on 14 to finally jump to 5th overall and 2nd in the two-wheel drive cup. Mikola Cimk, yes, taking advantage as well of Tempestini's punctures on 14, gaining one spot overall to finish 4th and 2nd in the production cup. Laszlo Vichin, second fastest on the stage, finishes 3rd overall and took his first IRC podium and also the first one for a Hungarian team. Good work. Robert Cossani, another quickest time on stage 13, jumping ahead of Vichin to 2nd overall and won the very last stage and finishes 2nd place. As we've said, hat-trick, yes really, with overall podium victory in both the two-wheel drive and the production cup. Phenomenal. Yagis Avci, well, a big winner of the Yalta. Yes, superb. The Turkish driver, amazing. Safe but efficient strategy, not taking too many risks and winning on his first outing in the IRC.
We are very, very happy at the moment. It was really, really big challenge for us. Completely new experience, and we try not to do any mistakes, keep it on the road, and actually the biggest challenge is with the stages, not with the rivals.
There we are. It was a proper strategy and it paid off. And look at the margin of victory, over 3 minutes clear of his nearest rival, Cossani, in the Renault again. Well, on September the 5th, 2012, The second day of this year's Yalta Rally, it was 5 years since the death of Colin McRae in that helicopter crash, so fateful. But his memory lives on.
Real hero in our sport.
Rally. For me, McRae means rally.
Unbelievable. He have no limits. He have the speed inside.
First of all, he was a very nice fellow. Hell of a rally driver as well. At least for me, it was a big shock when I heard what happened to him.
When I received the news about the accident, I was with Piero Liatti. He was in the same team. And it's a very, very black day.
A lot of time I meet with Colin in the World Championship. And for me, it was extraordinary when he rolled three times the focus and arrived at the end with the pickup focus. I was there. It was really incredible. And really, for me, the essence of the rally is Colin.
Rally GB with Focus WRC is on board. And when I watched it, it was like fastened video. I mean, not real time, but it was real time, so it was so fantastic.
Colin McRae, I always remember when we had Petter Solberg's wedding and we had a good time with him there. That's the thing, and I still have a photo of him and me on that wedding, and that's the first thing I remember about him.
And what happened there on the wedding?
That's classified.
Well, those drivers that show the same quality of Colin McRae, courage, a feel for speed, they're always honoured with the Colin McRae Flat Out Trophy. In Yalta, the prestigious trophy went to Robert Cassani for the efforts that he showed. Second overall and the win in both the Production Cup and the Two-Wheel Drive Cup. Well earned indeed. Happy faces in Yalta. Superb. Vishin, Cassani and of course Avci, celebrating what was a fabulous result in an amazing venue. If you ever get to go, it's a beautiful, beautiful place. From me, Carlton Kirby, and the rest of the team. Bye-bye.